My name is John McKeeby. I'm the Clinical Information Officer of the Clinical Center of the National Institutes of Health. Today, we'll talk about the Clinical Data Interchange Standards Consortium, CDISC. We will first discuss the basics. From the Principles and Practice of Clinical Research book, CDISC is reviewed as the standards for clinical research. Standards exist for organizing clinical research data to enable sharing and aggregation. CDISC was created as a standard for submitting regulatory information to the FDA. CDISC with FDA, HL7, NCI combined efforts with the Biomedical Research Integrated Domain Group, Bridge, to operationalize CDISC. CDISC is a standards development organization whose focus is medical research data linked with healthcare. It's to enable information system interoperability to improve medical research in related areas of healthcare. The mission of CDISC is to develop and support global platform independent data standards to improve medical research in related areas of healthcare. It's to ensure interoperability between research and healthcare. It's to streamline the workflow from EHR's clinicians who conduct research. The benefits are reduced time to set up research, traceability from the EHR to the clinical research database, improved data quality, improved data sharing and interoperability across research organizations, reduce costs for setup and overhead of data analysis for the length of study, and increase predictability by creating repeatable and streamlined process. In another conversation, we talked about common data elements. CDISC provides standards, common data elements, and a common data model. CDISC importance is research studies can be initiated faster. Gartner reported in 2007 that it reduced setup time by 70 to 90%. It also allows research studies to significantly have fewer resources, both in time and personnel. It ensures the data quality and integrity that's higher than without having standards. It improves communication across the teams for research, across organizations, across stakeholders. It ensures data sharing and interoperability between systems and organizations. And it provides high quality reporting to FDA, clinicaltrials.gov, and other regulatory organizations. The guiding principles of CDISC are to develop standards of the highest quality to allow all researchers to leverage and share information from individuals and studies around the world, to facilitate the ability for implementers to effectively structure and analyze data so it's easily interpreted, understood, and navigated by regulatory reviewers. Ensure the standards are developed in a manner that emphasize content, structure, and quality, transcending implementation strategy and platform. Provide a global, multidisciplinary, cross-functional community of members, volunteers, and stakeholders from across the research spectrum to develop consensus-based standards. Collaborate and partner with fellow thought leaders and organizations on key initiatives to foster efforts to advance standards and semantics, and accomplish this without promoting any individual vendor or organization. Create a set of standards that is agnostic to any vendor. There's been many milestones. It started in 1997 as a volunteer group. It then became more formal in 2000, created as an independent nonprofit organization. Global participation started in 2001. And then the various standards have been created over time from 2001 to current. This is just a list of the major standards that were created by CDISC. In 2017, there was a paper that was created to review the importance of data standards in clinical research. And they identified the importance to promote interoperability. And in the paper, they specifically mentioned CDISC. You should use data standards that are common, known, and accepted, and that the data standards from CDISC should be considered as the best starting point for defining and coding data and metadata in a consistent way. They identified that CDISC is an operational data model that provides a good starting point. It provides metadata that provides one mechanism to remove ambiguity, and then it has the advantage of ensuring data traceability and provenance of data through the research process. Ways CDISC is used. It's an exchange format. It's used to exchange data utilizing XML format. We see that, and it's used to provide protocol data to clinicaltrials.gov, as well as pharmaceutical data to the FDA. CDISC provides a controlled terminology, common data elements. They create a common set of terms across therapeutic areas. And then as a reference model, a physical database, it's used as a common data model to establish semantic and syntax to share with stakeholders across studies.